Let's say you have a fully charged up 12-volt lead-acid battery that you want to use to power sensitive electronic circuits that can only handle 12 volts DC. Only problem is that the battery voltage starts out at 30.1 volts and drops over time to a cutoff voltage of 11 volts. Now of course we could use a buck converter to step down the voltage above 12 volts and a boost converter to step up the voltage below 12 volts. But needless to say, working with two circuits like this is rather impractical. The solution is a so-called buck boost converter, which can step up and step down DC voltage in a fluent manner. And in this video I will show you how such a circuit works and how you can easily build one yourselves. Let's get started. The topology and working behavior of a buck and boost converter should be known by now. If not, make sure to watch my previous videos about the subject. But in a nutshell, the buck converter outputs a voltage smaller than the input voltage, dependent on the duty cycle of the used switch, and the boost converter outputs a voltage higher than the input voltage, dependent on the duty cycle as well. So, wouldn't it be convenient if we could just put the two circuits in series? Well, this method actually exists, and after removing the unnecessary capacitor in the middle and combining the two coils in series to a single one, we have successfully created a non-inverting buck boost converter. When switch 1 is closed, the buck portion is inactive and switch 2 controls the step-up factor. And if switch 2 is open, the boost portion is inactive and switch 1 controls the step-down factor. But since we need to control two switches, aka two MOSFETs, this is not the simplest circuit yet, because that would be the so-called inverting buck boost converter, aka flyback converter. All we need is a switch, a coil, a capacitor, and a diode. When the switch is closed, current flows through the coil, which then builds up its electromagnetic field and thus stores energy. While that is happening, the diode prevents current from flowing to the capacitor, and the capacitor itself supplies its previously stored energy to the attached load. Once the switch opens, the stored energy of the coil is then transferred into the capacitor by charging it up, and the cycle repeats. But it is noticeable that the positive and negative side of the capacitor is located opposing to the voltage input. That is why it is called an inverting buck boost. For my prototype circuit, I will use a 0.03 mH SMD coil, a 220 microfarad capacitor, a 1N5819 Schottky diode, and a MOSFET as a switch. Normally I would use a p-channel MOSFET to easily accomplish high side switching, but since its resistance is 10 times higher than an n-channel type, I simply change the position of the switch so that I can use the RLZ44N n-channel MOSFET. After building up the circuit on a breadboard, all that was missing was a square wave signal with variable duty cycle for the MOSFET switch. For that, I used an 80Tiny85, which outputs the required signal on pin 6 with variable duty cycle according to the position of a potentiometer on pin 7. But obviously, I programmed the microcontroller beforehand with my homemade programming shields. After adding a small load on the output of the converter and hooking up my power supply and the probes of my oscilloscope, it was time to correlate the duty cycle with the output voltage. By using a small duty cycle below 9%, the transferred energy of the coil is rather low and only allows output voltages below the input voltage, so it is in buck mode. But once we use a duty cycle above 9%, the energy of the coil is enough to reach a higher output voltage than the input voltage. So it is in boost mode. But here's the problem. If I attach a bigger load to the output, the border between buck and boost mode moves upwards to a duty cycle of 29%. So a duty cycle of, for example, 20% might represent 8.8 volts for big loads, but around 25 volts for small loads. And that is something a normal buck boost converter does not do. It has a fixed output voltage, so we have to get rid of it. Supplying a feedback voltage to the microcontroller and changing the duty cycle according to the set voltage by the potentiometer would be a decent solution. But since our output is inverted, we cannot directly connect it, unless we want wrong values. What we need is an op amp, which needs to be configured as a differential amplifier with 20 kilo ohm and 5.1 kilo ohm resistors in order to scale the maximum output voltage of 20 volts down to suitable 5 volts for the microcontroller. After reprogramming the ADTiny, this circuit held its output voltage steady no matter what kind of load I attached, so it was time to create a more permanent version of it. For that, I firstly created a fitting schematic with the help of the free EasyEDA circuit design software. And if you want to build something similar, then you can find the code, this schematic and everything important in the video description. Afterwards, I created a small piece of perf board, gathered all the necessary components and started soldering the components to one another according to the schematic. At the end of the soldering process, I used a bit of extra wire to establish the connections that were not realizable with silvered copper wire, and just like that, the circuit was complete. Now my sensitive 12-volt only circuit can easily be powered by lead-acid batteries, but it is mentionable that there are also disadvantages. In my application example here, the boost converter reaches an efficiency of 95%, the buck converter an efficiency of 88%, and the buck boost converter only an efficiency of 80% in boost and buck modes. So the circuit can do both, but not as good as each function individually. I hope you liked this video and learned something new as well. As always, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Stay creative! And I will see you next time.